Welcome back. Over the centuries, it's been lauded as everything from an aphrodisiac to a heart-healthy treat, but let's face it, chocolate's greatest appeal is that it just brings out the kid in us. Since I was a kid, reading Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, I dreamt of becoming a chocolatier, a dream come true in this week's postcard from B-Web. From its medicinal value to the golden smiles it creates, chocolate is almost mythical in its appeal.
Don't lose your heads. Don't get overexcited.
And so to Paul's Valley I went, seeking secrets of Oklahoma's greatest chocolatier.
Brent, welcome to Bedre Chocolates, and we're glad to have you here this morning, and I'm going to give you some of the proper attire for work in a chocolate factory, and we're ready to go.
Instantly upon entering the Bedre Fine Chocolate Factory, I learned that this was not as intimidating as Willy Wonka's. No, this isn't Grandpa Bucket's Chocolate Factory. The attire, the assembly line, the workers all seemed a little less dangerous than Wonka's.
What's so funny?
Even Augustus Gloop couldn't get himself into trouble following this chocolate pipeline. They even let me try my hand at creating their signature chocolate-covered chips.
There's not really a secret. It's pretty simple.
Yeah, right. And after a few broken chips and some decreased productivity, it didn't take Oompa Loompas to usher me to the end of the line.
You did like this? Pick them up?
Make a big stack? Oh, man. What happens if you start getting all messed up and just go...
No,
where I discovered there are indeed some similarities between great chocolate makers. Attention to detail, efficiency, and quality control. Not to mention the seriousness with which they each guard what separates them from their competition. So ultimately, I decided to give up my dream of owning the factory like Charlie Bucket and leave the finer points of fine chocolate to the professionals, sticking to the one thing I do best, putting the taste to the test. Jin Gentry joins us now from Bedre Fine Chocolates in Paul's Valley. Thanks for joining us this morning, Jin.
Thank you.
Bedre, owned by the Chickasaw Nation, by the way, and you're getting ready to add some seasonal employees because it gets busy now, doesn't it?
It's very busy right now. We're doing all of our big work, getting ready for Christmas, and then Valentine's is right behind it, so.
And you've actually added, you guys are known for the Bedre crisps, which are chocolate-covered chips, and until you taste one, you have no idea how good it is. But you've added a little twist to that same thought process, by the way, haven't you? Show us the new stuff and all of the things that Bedre's working on.
The new products, I can't say the name of what they are, but you used to eat them off your fingers.
Those little things. Corn chippy things.
Yeah, they're corn, kind of a corn base to them.
But we don't want to say it.
But then we drizzle them with chocolate for a special customer that we have, kind of a unique thing. These are the chocolate-covered potato crisps. We have the cow patties, the Oklahoma cow patties. We've got the Centennial coin, so those are really great.
And you know what's really cool? This is all made with your special recipe stuff. So a lot of times you see specialty candies in places, and it's really not the good stuff. You know what I mean? It just kind of looks good, but this is all the regular stuff that you get. For example, go to Hard Rock Casino, you get a special thing on your pillow there, don't we?
Yep, all the Hard Rocks, we do a little guitar for them. But like you said, they don't have any waxes or paraffins in them, so they do melt, and that's a good thing. But the insides of these mints have not like a gooey kind of center, but more like a fudge base, so that's really good. There's caramel, there's these are the twists, and then we've got bars. We have a white chocolate coated popcorn with pecans and almonds in it. The hats, Oklahoma molds, just... We can do just about anything you like.
Now, you actually are a member of the Chickasaw Nation tribe.
I am Chickasaw.
And you're you know, the employees there obviously are, it's a labor of love, but it's not a huge factory like the Willy Wonka factory. Still, you reach to a lot of places. Tell us some of your customers.
We do. We sell to Brahms, Neiman Marcus, just recently Bloomingdale's, and Gosh.
And in places, there are a lot of specialty ones, too. And by the way, also, a lot of sugar-free stuff is absolutely amazing. Well, Jin Gentry, really appreciate you being here. It was a great treat to get down to see how they're made and get behind the scenes. And by the way, if you go to the factory, you can bring a cooler or just buy their little ice packs and because of the quality of the chocolate, it does melt pretty easily, and that's a good thing. Find out more about them. Go to our website, okcfox.com. We'll click you over to theirs. As we head to break, you see some of the